Very good evening, friends. Meeting again in the session of Organon philosophy, and we are discussing the new chapter, that is the dynamic action of the drug. In this specific chapter, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, in H.A. Robert, has tried the Samuel Hahnemann's concepts regarding the action of the drugs, the scientificity behind that. He tried to explain over there. He is explaining certain examples. And while explaining those, he is taking the references that what Morgan says or what the people, other people talks about those things. So we were on the page number 105. We have finished first paragraph, but we'll again read that, and then we'll go ahead. So let us look at a recent book published dealing with the mode of action of drugs on cells by A.J. Clark. AB, MD, FRCP, FRS, Professor of Dermatomedica at the University of Edinburgh, formerly Professor of Pharmacology in the Universities of London and Cape Town. This book deals with the matter entirely from the orthodox medical viewpoint. Yet here is comment relative to the biological response of the cell drugs reaction. So what he says, that Mr. A.J. Clark, there is indeed very little direct evidence that biological response is produced by chemical reactions between the drugs and cell constituent. This assumption is chiefly justified by the fact that it is supported by much indirect evidence, and that there is no alternative hypothesis which was stronger evidence in its support. If we assume that there is some relation between the amount of drugs entering into the combination and the extent of biological response, then the following consideration must apply. If the fundamental chemical reaction consists in fixation of the drug by some particular constituent of the cell, then this must result in reduction both of the free drug and of the free receptor in the cell. The relative amount of drug solution and cells can, however, be varied at will. And hence, the concentration of the drugs can always be kept constant by providing a sufficient excess of drug solution. Indeed, in many cases, the quantity of the drug fixed is so minute that it is difficult to reduce the drug solution to a volume small enough to show changes in concentration. Drugs that act in high dilutions are of particular interest in pharmacology. And in such cases, true adsorption may be delayed by depletion of layer adjoining the surface. Friendlich states that the simpler the conditions chosen and the smaller the difficulty in securing access to the inner surface, the quicker is the adsorption. In the case of well-powdered adsorbents, the equilibrium is mostly reached in seconds or minutes. So these are the references which he is trying to show that how these drugs, the homeopathic drugs, they act. The specific action of the drugs through the scientific aspect. He is taking the example, or he is taking the references from the different scientific books through which he tried to explain the concept that there are in your body, there are receptors which are to which they are reacting to any stimulus which comes right from there in the form of some chemicals that might be in a very small quantity, even a minute quantity, the body reacts. And that reaction is very important. It varies from the quantity of the drugs. If it is minimum, then also it reacts. Even though it is negligible, then also it reacts. So these are the different references why our remedies, even though they are in so minute quantity that they are nearly unmeasurable, still homeopathic body reacts to it and produces certain reaction. The action of drugs depends upon all those things. So it is not just a dynamic action. It is the action which is not visible to naked eye. That's why we call it by dynamic. Ultimately, it is nothing but our own chemicals or receptors which are present over there, and the adsorbent area is there on cell, which to which this stimulus makes its impression and body reacts. And that's why our remedies, even though in minute quantity, they react. He's trying to force on you that this is not just a dynamic, just a spiritual. It is something which is scientific, which has scientific evidence. And for that purpose, he's trying his level best to explain it, that even though it is the very minute quantity, it works. What he further says, in the case of cell drug solution system in which vigorous stirring is possible, delay ought to be reduced. It is, however, necessary to remember that particles above a certain size carry with them a layer of water several micra thick, even when they are stirred thoroughly. Hence, even in cases where such stirring is possible, the delay due to the depletion cannot be ignored. So, one more point which he has elaborated or explained over there in earlier paragraph, that if it is not a compound, if it is a simple drug substance, then the reaction is very fast. The absorption is very fast and reaction is very fast. If it is compound, then reactions are little bit slow. And this thing is very important. That's why Hahnemann says that give you a single simple substance is most important, because the reactions are very fast over there. And whenever you stir, so whenever you do a succussion, whenever you do a trituration, the adsorption reaction is very fast, because of which it is possible to show very fast reactions at that level. And then he says, in other words, even modern pharmacology recognizes, number one, the reaction of amount of drug so minute that it is not possible to tell how small the amount of drug in the solution is, yet it still shows definite action on the cell. So modern pharmacology also accepted that thing. So they tried, first they were giving large doses, then they reduced it. Even they have made the colloidal solutions also in modern pharmacology. They are coming to the same idea, that as you reduce the drug substance, it is fine to be get penetrated inside the body. Second important indication which he indicates over there in the modern pharmacology, the action is much more rapid in case of well-powdered substances. So that is also a thing which has been mentioned by modern pharmacology, that if you make it fine and triturate, the action is very fast, rapid. And third important thing which the modern pharmacology says, regardless of the quantity of the drug used, the solution is activated to a marked degree by vigorous stirring. So succussion is third important thing by which how much quantity is used, it is not of any importance. The degree of stirring makes the difference in the reaction of the body. So this is not homeopathy. This is modern pharmacology. The scientific pharmacology itself explains that the processes which we used to use in our homeopathy for the preparation of medicine, they are scientific methods of preparation. This is the scientific evidence which he tried to explain to you. Then he further says, this shows the observation of the action of infinitesimal amounts of drugs on physiological basis, that the greater the trituration, more rapid the action, and that the influence of the succussion also speeds up rate of activity markedly. But the comprehension of vital principles upon which homeopathy is based does not follow the observations remarked by Professor Clark. So this is what modern pharmacology says. So if you make it more triturate, then it will act, or body will react in a faster way. If you make it more and more succussed, then the reaction will be very fast. And this is the truth. This is accepted, but people are not looking toward those observations. It is but natural that many prescribers at first stay close to the mechanical or chemical stages, for the material always first attracts our attention. But in order to grasp this truth of dynamization, we must apply the same means of approach and travel the same road that Hahnemann and his followers have traveled. Recognizing the dynamic in health, and in the disease, and applying the same line of thought and reason to the study and development of power and action of drug. So, material we get attracted because we have learned right from childhood till today, we have learned the material mathematics, material science, only physical science. And because of which we get very easily attracted to certain things, the material thing. But if you go towards this dynamic, making the drugs, the crude drug substance into activity by making it finer and finer and applying the force in the form of trituration or succussion, we make the medicine more powerful because the properties and energy which gets liberated because of this method. So this indicates that whatever the measures which have been developed by Hahnemann in order to go for potentization is very scientific, and it is not just a Hahnemann thought. It is well to note the care and thoroughness of Hahnemann's work and methodical way in which he developed the potency. Using the centesimal scale in preparing his divided doses and giving each step in the process vigorous succussion. This process was continued until all trace of the quantity has vanished. Beyond the recognition of all possible physical tests, yet these higher potencies, the dynamic qualities or potential qualities survive. Upon applying these potencies upon man and or animals, we find a far more delicate organism or apparatus than is provided in the any possible physical instrument or as it develops. Possible the furthest development of radioactive power may in time give us a measuring instrument that may be partially reveal this ability. But the human organism will always be most delicate instrument for the susceptible subjects in quick respond to this dynamic power. So he is giving explanation that whatever the Hahnemann have thought in order to develop this potency had a significance. It is not just Hahnemann's thought. Hahnemann studied the science behind that. He studied the physics, he studied the chemistry, he studied the biology, all things. And then he came to the conclusion of that methods of potentization, the trituration and succussion. He understood that when you reduce it by a certain applying force continuously in a specific mathematical proportion, you are releasing the quantity of medicine, but releasing the energy which is centered in that specific atom. If you release it, that remedy works wonderfully. That remedy has very specific action. And this scientificity he tries to explain over there. So as you make it more and more finer and more and more dynamic, the properties gets liberated and it works beautifully in the patient. So this chapter is dedicated to explain this reason, that dynamic action of the drugs, how it happens and why it happens. And then he turns further and explains, we are dealing here in the realm of imponderables and encounter the problems beyond the reach of men's analysis, the realm where we can only observe the effects alone. However, all we can see and all we can hope to know in our observation of human beings is the effects of growth and development. And it is so with our study of medicinal action. This is so not only the study of the potency, but it is so almost entirely in the study of crude drug, their action, as well as our study of foods and their action. The effects are there to be seen, but the imponderable nature of the modus operandi is beyond our comprehension. The very same line of evidence is produced in all these fields. It is the effects only that are manifest to us. The observations must be recorded, and only by deduction can we comprehend their innermost meaning. Many mistakes have been made by failing to follow the rules laid down by Hahnemann in his Organon of Healing. Follow these rules and results will be order and observable. So what he is saying again? He is saying again same thing, that there is one kingdom from which we prepare the medicine. The kingdom is imponderable. And what is there in imponderable here? We prepare medicines from certain things. Even we can prepare the medicine from moonlight. We are preparing the medicines from magnets, magnetic power, and all those medicines which we used to prepare by that method, they works. How they works? Nothing is materially there, but still they work. We have to believe certain things because we have to believe on the specific cause and effect. We have to believe that moon itself, moon's gravitational pulse, it itself is responsible to produce the tide and ebbs. So if this is truth, then we have to believe that a same moon energy, we can produce certain effects on human body. If it produces effects on human body, then definitely, if we prepare medicines from those imponderables, have effects on human body. And it is not just speculation, it is a fact. This is proving done, and then thereafter we have prepared the medicine. We have medicines from the magnetic poles. We have medicines from the moonlight. We have medicines from the solar plexus, solar rays. So these medicines which we used to get from those imponderable sources have their effects on human body, and those are facts. Those are not the speculation. Those are not the thoughts. And if it is so, how can you say this is unscientific? The action of medicines is scientific because it has been proved and scientifically proved. Only thing is that we have to follow whatever the rules laid down by Hahnemann. How he has prepared the medicine, how one should go and prove the medicine. All the rules and regulations which he has mentioned over there, if you follow by order, then definitely we'll have the same results and we can confirm it and explain it scientifically. And then he says, further, many of the graduates from homeopathy college do not grasp the dynamic concept of drug. And for that reason, always stay in material plane, using only the crude drugs and venturing into the low potencies occasionally. This is unfortunate for the efficacy of their work. For once, this concept is grasped, they realize that all potencies are valuable and useful, and they soon obtain the knowledge and power over disease little realized when viewed solely from the material plane. So what he is explaining over there, he is explaining over there the specific thing. Especially is this true in chronic trouble, for the test of real skill is in the cure of chronic patients and eradication of the chronic miasm. So he is explaining over there the specific truth which we used to find it out when we prove our remedies and their efficacy. But what happens, many graduates from homeopathy, they never understand the concept of dynamization. Because problem is that we never learned these dynamics. We learned only materials. And when we entered into the field of homeopathy, things are reversed. They are absolutely changed. There is no question of material, but things of immaterial comes. And then question arises. Then we consider that 200 is more powerful than 30, and 1 m is more powerful or more strong than 30. All those concepts, because we used to measure it materially, because 200 is more, has a big value than the 30. 1000 has a big value than 200, because we measure it in the material form. But we don't understand the dynamics behind that. We have to understand the dynamics. As we go on increasing the potency, the original material content of the medicine vanishes. It goes down and down, down and down. And that's why it only liberates the energy, and that becomes strongly an energy medicine. Unless and until we understand this concept properly, we cannot practice. Even Kent himself was not satisfied with this concept unless until he saw his wife treated with the help of homeopathic medicines with such small globules and immaterial dose of the medicine. And then he started believing that homeopathic doses work. Then in one case itself, which he has treated, a case of cholera, a child, as good as he was on death verge, he has prescribed some remedy, maybe arsenic or something, in 200 potency. And he was expecting that child would die. And he was not believing on hypotensives, but first time he has utilized that. And he was in his mind, he was in the thought that there would have been a funeral process going on in child's house, because he was going in the same way. So he was expecting that second day. But second day when he was coming, the child was playing over there in the ground. And he considered how this has happened, that 200 potency, three doses make a miracle. And then Kent started believing. So this happens with everyone, because we have not learned the concepts of dynamics. And unless and until we utilize, we experience, we cannot believe. And this is the problem of every homeopathic student. They cannot believe because they have not utilized. Unless and until you utilized and experienced, it is not possible. Further, he says, the use of the attenuated potency varies with each individual because of his interpretation of the law of dose. Hahnemann's question as to the how far the dose of homeopathic remedy in any given case of the disease ought to be reduced in order to derive from it the best possible cure is one we may well ask. So it varies. The dose of the medicine varies. There are many times students ask you that, sir, what medicine you have given, and second, in what potency? The question always comes regarding the potency. And there are many queries and stress, many confusions in people's mind. Because whenever it has been, if I want to teach material doses, then it becomes rather simple to teach. Then I can say, yes, 1 milligram per kilogram of body weight or 10 milligram per kilogram of body weight. It's too simple. But things when becomes dynamic, it is rather difficult. It comes close to the dynamics, you have to go on judgment. Then the question of judging the susceptibility, then the question of miasm, then the question of constitution, then the question of pathology, then the question of what type of disease it is, all things which you have to take into consideration before coming to the conclusion of potency. So medicinal action depends upon all those factors which we have to take into consideration, whether it is child, whether it is young, whether it is infant, whether it is child, whether it is adolescent, whether it is adult, whether it is old, everything which we have to take into consideration. At the same time, whether he is male or female, that also we have to take into consideration when we select the potency. So action of the drug, there are many factors which we have to choose. And this is what he is explaining over there, that these are entities which one has to understand. So I think we'll stop over here, and we'll meet directly on Wednesday. Wednesday we'll meet, because it is not possible on Monday and Tuesday there will be a inspection in our college. So I'll be there. We'll meet directly on Wednesday for the lecture, and then we'll continue with the chapter. So that's all for today. Thank you being there, and a very good evening. Today evening, most probably we're going to discuss the phosphorus in today's session. Okay? Phosphorus from Alan's skin. Thank you.